afternoon. Here's what's making news this Monday, the 15th of January. An Aussie queen, Australia's very own Princess Mary, ascends to the Danish throne. Penny Wong departs on her Middle East diplomacy mission as the region marks 100 days of war. Prime Minister Anthony Albanese recommits to stage three tax cuts. What this will mean for Aussie families. A Brisbane Woolworths vandalised after the company stopped selling Australia Day-themed merchandise. And award season ramps up, the latest on the big winners as the stars step out for the Critics' Choice Awards.
This is 10 News First Midday with Narelda Jacobs.
Kaya, and great to have your company. Roaring crowds have marked a new royal era in Denmark, which now not only has a king, but an Australian-born queen. And so it wasn't just Danes, but also Australians who were among the many thousands converging on Copenhagen to watch history unfold. Our correspondent Alice Hogg is there.
Well, Denmark has a new king and an Australian-born queen who've been welcomed by enormous crowds in Copenhagen. They came from near and far, and while it wasn't snowing at the time, they were undeterred by the cold to watch history unfold. From when the then Crown Prince and Crown Princess left their palace residence by car to their appearance on the balcony of Christiansborg Palace following the abdication of popular Queen Margrethe II, with the stroke of a pen, she passed the throne to her son, making him Denmark's King Frederick X. Many Australians were in these crowds too, later packing out an event hosted by the Australian ambassador. And before this snow arrived, Copenhagen's sky was lit up in bursts of red and white as a fireworks show marked the end of a significant day for the nation.
How lovely, Alice Hogg there. Foreign Minister Penny Wong has departed for the Middle East, becoming the first senior Australian government official to visit the region since war broke out 100 days ago. Chloe Boris has more.
Penny Wong will be reiterating Australia's calls, this time in person, for a sustainable ceasefire in Gaza. The foreign minister left Adelaide this morning. Over the week, she'll visit Jordan, Israel, occupied Palestinian territories and the United Arab Emirates. During her trip to the Middle East, she'll meet victims of the October 7 attack by Hamas, though she won't be visiting the site itself, and that has angered Australia's Jewish community. She will also meet Palestinian victims of Israeli settler violence. The foreign minister says she'll be advocating for the protection of civilians, avoidance of a regional escalation, and finding a path to peace.
Australia is not a central player in the Middle East, but we are a respected voice. And I'll be using our voice to advocate for a pathway out of this conflict. We all know that pathway can only be found by the parties to the conflict.
Today marks 100 days since the conflict broke out.
Chloe Boris there. As the Foreign Minister heads to the Middle East, a cross-party group of Australian politicians has launched last-ditch bids to prevent Julian Assange's extradition to the US. Liberal MP Bridget Archer, Greens Senator David Shoebridge, Labor MP Josh Wilson and Independent MP Andrew Wilkie have written a joint letter to the British Home Secretary. They say the do-or-die scenario would leave the WikiLeaks founder vulnerable to suicide if his final appeal is rejected. Assange will have to face espionage charges and could receive decades of prison time if he is extradited. Two British High Court judges will review the case next month and hand down what's expected to be a final ruling. Prime Minister Anthony Albanese has today made it clear he'll still follow through with stage three tax cuts he committed to at the last election. The PM was reportedly under pressure after refusing to guarantee the cuts in a recent interview. While the measure is seen by the Labor left as rewarding the country's highest earners, some of his MPs are warning any watering down of the policy could impact middle-income earners. But this morning, Mr Albanese says the government's position hadn't changed. The tax cuts are set to take effect from July 1 this year. Accused Bourke Street killer Zain Khan has appeared in Melbourne's Magistrates Court this morning. Khan has been charged with one count of murder and three counts of attempted murder after allegedly ploughing a white Toyota Orion into vehicles and pedestrians on Bourke Street in Melbourne CBD. The hearing quickly descended into chaos as Khan repeatedly interrupted the judge. The court has now been adjourned. The Victorian government is defending the secret use of millions in taxpayer funds to support Tennis Australia during the COVID pandemic. Documents obtained by The Age reportedly show the state government approved a bailout of up to $63 million. Treasurer Tim Pallas approved the funds, apparently to ensure Tennis Australia could pay for additional costs incurred by tournaments held in the pandemic years. Last year, the organisation reported a surplus of $62 million. Acting Premier Ben Carroll says the money was justified, helping generate $300 to $400 million in economic benefits for the state each year. Coming up, a global day of protests as supporters of both Israel and Palestine mark a sombre milestone. And volcano eruptions, houses ablaze as molten hot lava flows through the streets of Iceland.
Ago, a phenomenon took the world by storm. Now, a new era begins. A new tribe of superstar gladiators will take on everyday Aussies. Gladiators start 7:30 tonight on 10 and 10 Play.
Got a craving for a calming snack? Must be Cuca Clock. Whether you're collecting a carload of cranky kids, queuing for your commute, or cramming for a quiz, there's no quicker way to crush a craving than Cuke's Baby Cucumbers.
They say you can't live life in your comfort zone.
Well, we say,
yes, you can.
And you should. With the help of Earthwool Insulation, it's the easiest way to turn your home into a comfort zone. Make your home a comfort zone with Earthwool. Available at Bunnings Warehouse.
This summer at Macca's, value means more than ever. Like our loose change menu, which now comes with a lot more sharing. There's also more family time, thanks to the Macca's bundle range. And rewards and deals every week on the My Macca's app mean more reasons to treat yourself. Whatever it means to you, value means more at Macca's.
You could go to great lengths to fill the room with fresh fragrance. Or try Airwick scented oil plug-ins. Enjoy fragrance infused with natural essential oils for up to 100 days of freshness. Now that's a breath of fresh Airwick.
You always want to be in control. To live life fully. Get professional looking results while also taking care of your skin. Discover the Veet Expert range. Your body, your expectations, our products. Veet Expert.
Welcome to Deal or No Deal, 6 p.m. weeknights from February 5 on 10 and 10 Play.
Back to those promised Stage 3 tax cuts, and Oxfam Australia is among those urging the Prime Minister to scrap them. Oxfam says the cuts will only line the pockets of those doing okay in this cost of living crisis and would fuel inflation. For more, we're joined by Oxfam CEO Lynn Morgain. Lynn, thanks for joining us. Now, under the Stage 3 tax cuts, which are 6 months away, those earning $45,000 to $200,000 would be lumped in the same tax bracket of 30%. Now, so why are those at the higher end of this bracket be benefiting more?
Yes, that's right. So the effect of the Stage 3 tax cuts is that, you know, the top 10% get 50% of the benefit, and those in those low-income ranges like 45,000, you know, really, it's negligible, the impact for them. And the concern that Oxfam Australia has is that there is a dire need for public revenue right now. We're not making the kind of contribution we should be making globally to support other nations by our own standards. We're falling well short of that. And here at home, we've got Australians who are inadequately housed as a result of fire and flood. So this is the wrong time to be giving revenue to those who need it least.
Lyndon, the Prime Minister said this morning that stage three tax cuts will happen, but the government's looking at other ways to address inequality, like strengthening Medicare, providing cheaper childcare. Will those sorts of measures help?
Of course they will, yes. I mean, you know, Oxfam is a strong supporter of social protection measures everywhere around the globe. So the Prime Minister's right, these kinds of policies and investments are important. But they don't address this critical issue, which is the contribution of the most wealthy. You know, those amongst us who have more than they could possibly spend are not contributing to the same degree as you or I. And I think ordinary Australians are very clear now that not only do we need that public expenditure, you know, we've lived through a pandemic, people are seeing increasing numbers of disasters happening more rapidly. So they know that there is a need for government investment. And quite rightly, they're keen to ensure the government has the money it needs to do what it needs to do.
Lyn, that wealth distribution has been outlined in Oxfam's inequality report, which has just been released. What does it tell us about that divide between wealth and poverty in Australia?
Yes, so that report is a global report Oxfam's been undertaking for many years now, and it seeks to track the distribution of income and particularly for the purpose of the alleviation of poverty. So our interest is how do we ensure that the two-thirds of the world's population that currently are inadequately housed or do not have access to food, how best might we properly resource that? And what the report points out is that we're facing a concentration of wealth that is deeply problematic for all of our societies and around the globe. So what the report says is that it's necessary for governments to intervene. It's essential at this point that governments implement things like wealth taxes and windfall taxes in order to claw back some of this benefit that corporations and wealthy individuals have achieved as a result of crisis and as a result of public investment. So what we say is that it is simply immoral and unacceptable to allow these concentrations of wealth when we're having trouble feeding and providing shelter for ordinary people here in Australia and around the world.
Most of us will never know what it feels like to have more money than you can possibly spend. What does that actually look like, and why are people holding on to that much money and not letting it flow back into the community?
Yeah, I often wonder about that myself, Narelda. I believe that these numbers are very, very difficult for ordinary people to get our heads around, right? Like, most of us can't get our head around what a billion is. In the last 2 years, our billionaires have doubled their fortunes. So we say there's practical evidence that you can't spend that money even if you want to. So we've seen that even in philanthropic sectors where we've seen very high net worth individuals make contributions to share their resources, you know, they make commitments and so on. The practical truth is it's very difficult. And for that reason, it's governments that need to claw back. It actually can't be done by the individuals, and corporations themselves are not well placed to redistribute those resources. That is absolutely the role of government. And so that's why we're keen to see government take these measures to ensure that the ordinary people around the world are able to have just a basic standard of living. After that, if people have more than they need, that's really not our problem. But our problem is absolutely the many millions of people around the world who simply will go to bed tonight without food and without adequate shelter.
Lyn Morgain, CEO of Oxfam Australia, thanks for joining us on Midday.
Thanks for your interest.
Houses have been set alight as lava flows into the streets of a small town in Iceland in the second volcanic eruption in less than a month. Residents of Grindavik have been evacuated as streams of molten rock advance on the fishing community. Other locals hadn't returned after being told to leave during the previous eruption. Authorities say no lives are in danger, and they're also not expecting an impact to air travel because the event hasn't generated any ash. Supporters of both Israel and Palestine are holding protests around the world 100 days since the October 7 Hamas attacks. Families of Israeli hostages still held in the Gaza Strip were among thousands who protested in Tel Aviv, calling for their government to bring them home. They also held 100 seconds of silence to mark the day.
There are 136 hostages and captives. We are waiting for them all, each minute, each second. They were kidnapped because the state failed, because we failed. And now we, the state, must do everything, everything to release them.
Those scenes were echoed in cities around the world, including Paris. At the same time, pro-Palestinian protesters raised their voice in places like Turkey and through the streets of Washington, D.C. As those protests play out, there's been no let-up to the violence in the conflict zone. A Palestinian journalist is among dozens killed in the latest round of Israeli airstrikes on Gaza. Citizens displaced by the ongoing ground offensive are also reflecting on the impact of the dramatic escalation of the conflict.
I have a small tent. The cold has killed us. There's no food. There is nothing. I can't give my children a carton of milk. My children are sick.
The death toll in Gaza now exceeds 24,000, while the October 7 attacks killed more than 1,100. A return of Donald Trump to the White House could be one step closer, with the former president expected to win his first Republican nomination contest in the US state of Iowa. The caucus gets underway tonight with a final poll showing the twice impeached president holds a clear lead over Florida Governor Ron DeSantis and former South Carolina Governor Nikki Haley. Arriving in Iowa overnight, Trump compared himself to a notorious American gangster.
My parents never had this in mind for me. They're looking down, they're saying, my son's been indicted four times. They didn't know what the word indictment means, neither did I. What does indictment mean? I got indicted. I got indicted more than the late great gangster, Alphonse Capone. You ever hear of Al Capone, Scarface? He killed people.
Extreme weather across the states has forced the candidates to cancel their in-person rallies, holding so-called tele-rallies instead. They're concerned temperatures of minus 26 degrees may also affect voter turnout. Milan Fashion Week has kicked off with men's autumn-winter collections for 2024 hitting the runway. Emporio Armani took inspiration from the high seas, while Dolce & Gabbana named their collection Sleek. Gucci's new creative director also unveiled his debut menswear collection to rave reviews, designed to capture the joy of life. Up next, the tech of the day's finance with our friends at Ausbiz.
The miraculous recoveries that will melt every dog lover's heart.
This is going to be literally life-changing.
New The Dog Hospital with Graham Hall starts 7:30 Thursday on 10 and 10 Play.
The Mitsubishi Triton Runout is on now with over $2,000 of bonus accessories available on current 23 model year GSR and GLS. Run in for the legendary Triton Runout. Nothing can frighten a Triton.
11 essential vitamins and minerals, low GI, protein,
high in fibre. It's amazing what they squeeze into an up and go.
What's that? It's amazing what they squeeze into an up and go. Oh.
Well, I guess it's a repack.
It's a repack.
We squeeze more good stuff in, so you can get more out. Also available in no added sugar.
Shopping online comes with digital threats. So turn on NordVPN. Steer clear of phishing websites and encrypt your online traffic. Get the deal now.
Beware bargain insurance regret, Jeanette. Next time, go with Amy instead. Who offers great value cover you won't regret? Amy does.
However these six symptoms of heartburn and indigestion feel to you, they're all caused by acid reflux. Gaviscon Dual Action acts in the stomach to neutralise acid fast and forms a protective layer. For long-lasting relief of six symptoms, think Gaviscon. And if you suffer from any of these six symptoms frequently, try Guardium from Gaviscon, the heartburn experts. One tablet gives you 24-hour protection from frequent heartburn. Guardium.
Malcolm, you've broken everything!
Where are we going to get the money?
You need Wallet Wizard. Fast and easy cash loans. WalletWizard.com.au.
Summer just got tastier, a little crispier, and a whole lot smoother. Value means more with our new Loose Change menu.
With a single touch, germs are left behind to grow. Glen 20 24-hour protection helps prevent bacteria growth even after a single touch. Plus, kills viruses including COVID-19. Glen 20, for longer-lasting protection.
When accidents happen, you question everything.
Will I lose my job? Who will earn the money? What do I do next?
You call GMP Law. We ensure you recover physically and financially because we fight to get you 100% compensation in the minimum time possible. That's what we do, and we're damn good at it. And it's why there are no fees unless you win. Call GMP Law today. 100% expert, 100% compensation.
When you apply for a loan, lenders look at your credit score and report. And right now, our partner, Now Finance, has no fees, great rates. That's clear. That's ClearScore. Sign up for free today.
Did you know cockroaches crawl on food we leave out? Mortine Power Guard Easy Reach kills cockroaches in one spray and 99.9% of the germs they carry.
More smart, more safe, Mortine.
The old guard think they can keep out the new people with impunity. Don't worry, I have a plan.
The war is heating up.
I'm not surprised.
The Gilded Age, now streaming only on Paramount Plus.
Let's get a check of finance. And joining us is Andrew Gagan from AusBiz. Andrew, inflation is continuing to put pressure on Australian households.
That's right, Narelda. You, of course, only need to look at your weekly grocery bill to realise there's little relief in prices at the moment. Just taking a look at the latest read coming from the Melbourne Institute's monthly inflation gauge and cost of living report, recording higher consumer prices in December. Annual changes in the cost of living also rose across a range of household groups, particularly for self-funded retirees. The latest official read of inflation showed prices in the services sector remain stubbornly high as businesses pass on higher cost of labour to the consumer. More specifically, price pressures have been driven by rents, which rose around 7% in November, while electricity soared more than 10%, Narelda.
And Andrew, the demand for workers remains strong.
Yeah, in fact, taking a look at the read on online jobs, they were mostly steady in December. That's following a sharp fall we saw in the previous month. Data from ANZ and employment website Indeed showed online job ads edged up 0.1% in December, having fallen more than 5% in November. It suggests demand for workers remains strong overall, even if the labour market is loosening. But to put it in context, job ads are 36% higher than pre-COVID levels. The biggest decreases came from food preparation and services. ANZ economists expecting slower employment growth this year for an increasing unemployment rate alongside lower inflation as the population growth slows, Narelda.
How are the markets looking today, Andrew?
Yeah, pretty flat today thus far. Taking a look at the ASX 200, up marginally higher. In fact, or as I just speak, in fact, it's just dropped. So let's call it flat. Stocks specifically, uranium stocks are surging along with the uranium price led by Paladin. Super Retail, which owns Super Cheap Auto, Rebel and BCF, it's rising on positive trading update. Evolution among the gold miners that are higher today. And Liontown leading the lithium stocks lower. ANZ also rising today. Let's take a look at the Aussie dollar. It's trading a little lower there, just about, closer to 67 US cents at the moment, in fact. And in terms of those commodity prices, both gold and oil are higher at the moment. So there we go. There's a take a look at those two commodities. Narelda.
Thank you, Andrew Gagan from AusBiz. Still ahead today, flash flooding warnings as Sydney is soaked with heavy rainfall. Plus, a surprising reason behind a new surge in Aussies booking cruises. And the new project keeping Aussie tennis great Ash Barty busy in retirement. Now to a quick check on today's weather around the country. Brisbane, 30 degrees and some rain. Sydney, the rain will continue, 24. Melbourne, partly cloudy, 28. Adelaide, sunshine, 34. Perth, 34 and some cloud around.
Tonight's on 10 and 10 Play.
Following their surprising success, Steamhunk are planning a multi-city world tour, playing 5 cities in 9 days. Manager Rodney has to book all the flights.
The budget's tighter than priceless leather pants.
So he's using Webjet, which compares flight combinations from hundreds of airlines worldwide, filtered by the cheapest, fastest and best results.
Sorted.
Do they have soy milk in Japan?
Easily book a multi-city trip yourself at Webjet.
Hungry Jack's new Texan Bacon Deluxe. Crispy bacon with double flame-grilled beef, Texan smoky barbecue and creamy peppercorn sauce. The new Texan Bacon Deluxe. The burgers are better at Hungry Jack's.
Headaches can impact performance. Unleash the speed of liquid with Nurofen Advanced Liquid Capsules for fast headache relief when it matters most. You do the top score. We'll do the headache relief fast.
Dude, it looks great, Barry.
I'm proud of it.
What timbre did you use?
It's Mirbu.
I think it'd be Mirbau.
Mirbu.
Mirbau.
Mirbu.
Mirbau.
Specrite Mirbu.
Mirbau.
Specrite Mirbu timber. Mirbau. Now available pre-oiled. Mirbau. Looks great, Mirbau. However you say it. Available at Bunnings Warehouse.
Mirbau!
Anything designed to carry the human body must be relentlessly refined and tested. The unique Sealy Posturepedic Spring System senses and responds, working to align your body so you can get straight into your day.
Okay, new year, new you, new plan. You order Light and Easy's new Jumpstart Pro, the dietitian design program to kickstart your weight loss journey. You get a convenient, on-the-go, high-protein breakfast shake. You get your choice of chef-designed lunches and dinners. You get a free app. And you get 38 years of experience. Doesn't matter if it's your first time or your 15th. It's time for a healthier way to lose weight. It's time for a fresh start with Light and Easy's new Jumpstart Pro.
A Woolworths in Brisbane has been targeted by vandals just days after the supermarket giant announced he will no longer sell Australia Day themed merchandise. Let's cross to 10 News First reporter Matthew Castunan in Brisbane. Matt, have there been any arrests?
Good afternoon, Narelda. Not at this stage, but police have spent most of the morning here at the Woolworths Metro at Tenerife, which is an inner city suburb of Brisbane, after a flare was thrown at the outside of the store and graffiti written on the front, all relating to Australia Day, January 26. I won't repeat what was written, but it happened at around 5 this morning. The units above the supermarket actually had to be evacuated, around 100 people or so, just as a precaution. But the supermarket chain has been under fire from some after last week announcing it would not stock Australia Day merchandise due to what they say was falling demand. Now, we spoke to some shoppers to get their reaction. Let's take a listen.
I was woken up at 5 a.m. by the sirens. Now that I know what it's about, I think it's disgusting, but I think it's disgusting what Woolies are doing about Australia Day merchandise.
I support Woolies with their decision. I think it's good. I think the Australia Day date needs to be addressed, but I don't think damaging property is the right way to get your opinion across either. So
everyone's right to have a right to an opinion, that's all cool, no problems with that, but just defeating other people's property is just, it's not the right thing to do, I don't think personally. So
now the debate around January 26 in Australia Day, of course, is very divisive, but as you can see, has taken an unexpected turbulence, and of course police are investigating, hoping to make that arrest. Narelda?
All right, thanks for that, Matthew. As we can see, it's pouring in Brisbane today, but new warnings are in place in Sydney as parts are smashed with heavy rainfall overnight, with the wet weather causing traffic chaos. Emergency services were called to Macquarie Park after a truck jackknifed, blocking all lanes, while roads in neighbouring suburbs were flooded. Authorities have issued alerts for possible flash flooding across the city and other parts of New South Wales, with heavy rainfall expected to continue in coming days. State emergency services have already received more than 100 calls for assistance, mostly for leaking roofs. Drivers are being urged to take care on the roads. The cruise sector in Australia is taking off, with new figures showing that 26% of Aussies are looking to the sea for their next holiday. Our reporter Keziah Dawn has more.
Narelda, well, a survey conducted by the Tourism and Transport Forum has indicated that one in four Australians are choosing to cruise this year. That's up from roughly 7% 12 months ago. Now, to take us through those survey results, I have Margie Osmond from the Tourism and Transport Forum. Margie, can you tell us what the results of that survey indicated?
Well, basically 2024 is clearly the year of cruise. As you say, one in four people, a big increase. So this tells you that the industry is in recovery mode now, seriously. And the cruise curious part of the marketplace, people who've never been on a cruise, have now decided this is something they really want to do, particularly those under 35.
And for families, what are the options for families on a cruise ship?
Well, there's all kinds of different cruise ships, but amongst the new Disney ships, for example, there's a wealth of opportunities, everything from major water slides through to dance classes to all sorts of kids club activities. So great for parents as well, because the kids can have a wonderful time and so can the parents. And P&O cruises, wonderful options there as well. And at the other end of the spectrum, you've got the new Virgin cruises with everything from yoga and tattoo parlours through to Korean restaurants.
Thank you so much for your time today. Now, the tourism cruise industry, injects roughly around $5 billion into the economy. So it is an important aspect of tourism in Australia. Narelda?
Keziah Dawn there. 2 years on from retirement, tennis star Ash Barty will today launch a new foundation at Melbourne's prestigious Kooyong Tennis Club with the mantra of support, grow, flourish. The Ash Barty Foundation will help encourage, inspire and influence the next generation of sporting legends through education and sport. The former world number one made a surprise cameo at the Australian Open last night alongside Andre Agassi, bringing out the champions' trophies to centre court at Rod Laver Arena. It's day two of the Australian Open, and tonight our nation's best hope, Alex de Minaur, will hit the court in a first-round clash with an unseeded Canadian. 10 News First reporter Jess Maggio has the latest from Melbourne Park.
It's day two of the Australian Open and attendance is already reaching record highs with just under 78,000 spectators on day one. The new record surpasses previous feats of 72,000 for day one in 2017. Organisers are hoping it's a sure sign to smash previous tournament turnouts to crack 1 million spectators across the 3 weeks. There was a huge crowd for Novak Djokovic last night at Rod Laver Arena, pushed to a four-hour, four-set match against teenage Croat Dino Prismic. A hell of a scare for the defending champion, who clearly felt the pressure having had a short outburst during set two, calling on the crowd to quieten down. It follows a move by AO organisers to allow fans to move freely around the stadium during the games. Previously, spectators had only been able to enter during a changeover between games. And new details have emerged today of a multi-million dollar taxpayer bailout of Tennis Australia. $63 million in contingency was paid to relieve Tennis Australia from debt incurred during the pandemic. The tournament did return to profitability last year with a record 840,000 spectator turnout, posting a surplus of $62 million. The government has defended the move, as has Australia Tennis, saying the Australian Open brings hundreds of millions of dollars in tourism to the state each year. It's a big day of Aussie talent on day two of the Australian Open, but all eyes will be on favourite Alex de Minaur at Rod Laver Arena tonight.
Thanks, Jess. Coming up after the break, the DIY kit making a life-saving test a little less uncomfortable.
Thursday, our Subway Socceroos continue their hunt for Asian Cup glory.
They've done it.
Don't miss Game 2, Socceroos, Syria.
Catch all the excitement of the Asian Cup live.
Thursday on 10 and 10 Play.
You've swallowed a trumpet.
Really?
That'll be expensive.
You bet.
Where are we going to get that sort of money from quickly?
Wallet Wizard!
Fast and easy cash loans.
Walletwizard.com.au.
As feelings go, winning millions is a pretty nice one. But you know what? There's something even nicer. Sharing your world with the people who make your world. And there's just no nicer feeling than that.
Wouldn't it be nice?
From the backyard beginners to our Aussie stars, cricket, it's for all of us. Buy any Dettol product to help us donate to the Woolworths Community Fund, because this is worth protecting. Bat, bowl, Dettol.
Play for Oz.
The next world champ.
Dunk like a beast.
Hope you've had your Weet-Bix.
Also available in Weet-Bix Bites. Try them today.
Imagine your own mimosa outdoors. The perfect garden oasis where you can sit back and relax with whoever you feel like inviting. A place where you can rest as comfortable as a cloud for a whole afternoon. Create your outdoor escape with a Mimosa Outdoors range.
Hey, Dad. What's the ocean like?
Are there animals living underwater? Is the ocean warm?
Yeah, it can be very warm.
You were made to remember some days forever. We were made to help you find the best way there.
Thanks to Vanish, you can revitalise your whites, even in short and cold cycles. Our OxyAction formula lifts away stains, removes odours, and helps keep your whites from greying over time. Clothes live longer with Vanish.
You always want to be in control. To live life fully. Get professional looking results while also taking care of your skin. Discover the Veet Expert range. Your body, your expectations, our products. Veet Expert.
G'day, I'm Russell Coit. So what's an old bushy like me doing behind the wheel of this fancy pants EV?
Bird watching. This EV is so quiet, they'll never hear me coming. Have a look at that.
I can't even hear the ball for
you.
I can wheel that steel.
How do you turn the radio off?
Styling, styling. How do I stop it? How do I hang it up?
Absolutely everything is on sale at Freedom. Right now, get up to 30% off all sofas and furniture and upgrade your outdoors with up to 50% off all outdoor furniture. Hurry, sale on now. Only at Freedom, home of summer.
It's a mountain of football on Paramount Plus.
Stream every game of the Asian Cup live only on Paramount Plus.
Australia, don't miss a minute.
The AFC Asian Cup, now streaming on Paramount Plus.
To some breaking news now, and a Tiwi Islands traditional owner, Simon Munkara, has lost his federal court case against the Santos Barossa gas export pipeline in the Timor Sea. Munkara had been seeking an injunction against the major project. And 10 News First will have more details as they come to hand. Far North Queensland is bracing for more flooding as a monsoon trough continues to dump heavy rain across the region. Locals in the town of Dagara are pleading for help after nearly 2 metres of rain swamped the community, destroying property. The Bureau of Meteorology says communities across the region can expect more monsoon showers and storms over the coming weeks. Thousands of Australians who previously skipped annual pap smears have now had their first cervical screenings, taking up the new option to do it themselves in private. Since the government expanded the eligibility of DIY kits in July 2022, there's been a 25-fold increase in participation. The new test involves a swab, similar in design to a COVID rapid antigen test, and no longer requires scraping of the vaginal wall. Anyone with a cervix aged 25 to 74 is eligible to self-test. It's been described as a gift to those dreading their biannual cervical cancer check. And for more, we're joined by Professor Marion Saville, Executive Director of the Australian Centre for the Prevention of Cervical Cancer. Professor, thanks for joining us. How do we access the DIY test? Can they be done at home?
So in the main, these tests, Narelle, will be offered by your GP at a community health service or an Aboriginal health service. There is some limited availability of at-home self-collection by some labs in conjunction with a telehealth consultation.
So you have to do it at the GP?
Typically, that's going to be the main way this happens, but provided that the test is ordered by a GP or a nurse practitioner, the collection can take place anywhere that GP thinks is appropriate.
So you can do it in the consult room behind a curtain, or you can take it into a bathroom. Why is scraping no longer needed?
Because we are no longer looking for the cells, the precancerous cells in the cervix before they turn into cancer. We're going a step earlier and looking for the virus that causes those cellular changes. That virus is shed into the vagina, and with the very sensitive PCR technology, we are now getting just as accurate results from self-collection as we would get if a GP or nurse had taken a sample from the cervix.
Professor, a lot of people experience discomfort during a pap smear, and there's a range of people that are now going for these tests for the first time. Can you talk us through the range of people who are now accessing pap smears?
Well, first of all, the people that we want to access cervical screening are those who are underscreened or never screened. And we know that disproportionately that affects Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people, members of the Rainbow community, people from some culturally and linguistically diverse groups, people who are less well off, and those who are living away from the big cities. So the further away you go, the less likely you are to be screened.
Is the sector, were they quite excited about this being a game changer for people accessing the tests and getting them done and preventing cancer?
Yeah, it's very exciting. We expect Australia to be the first country in the world to reach the WHO target for elimination of cervical cancer. But in order to get there faster and do so equitably, being able to bring everyone along through the use of self-collection, which really addresses many, many barriers and has been a breakthrough in acceptability, is so exciting for the sector.
Do you still need to pay a GP's fee to do this yourself?
So cervical screening does happen in primary care, typically general practice, and we all know it's getting harder to get a bulk bill consultation. So yes, that's a challenge. And there are other services though, community health services, Aboriginal health services. So, recognising that it's a challenge, but also that there should be ways that people can access cervical screening.
All right, do it yourself, cervical screening. Thank you very much, Professor.
Thank you for having me.
Up next, all the day's entertainment news with Angela Bishop, including the latest on the big winners as the stars step out for the Critics' Choice Awards.
A new school year means new school gear. The Williams Famous Back to School Shoe Sale is on now. Get 20% off school shoes by big brands Colorado and Clarks, all backed by our famous price match and perfect fit guarantees. Walk this way into Williams today.
The Mitsubishi Triton Runout is on now, with over $2,000 of bonus accessories. Available on current 23 model year GSR and GLS. Run in for the legendary Triton Runout. Nothing can frighten a Triton.
When you apply for a credit card, lenders look at your credit score and report to decide if they're going to lend to you. You can check your own credit score and report with ClearScore for free to understand your financial situation. Right now, we've partnered with Latitude to give you 6 months interest-free on everyday purchases of $250 or more, and see how likely you are to be approved before you apply. That's clear. That's ClearScore. Sign up for free today.
What kind of crazy life hack is this?
The dishwasher doesn't dry the dishes well enough.
Try Finish Rinse.
For 2 times better drying, including on plastic, improving shine and protecting glasses.
Finish, the real life hack.
We've got a new, bigger and better cleaning range. We've got leading brands, and because we're a warehouse, the savings are amazing. Where you find a competitor's lower price on the same stocked item, we'll beat it by 10%. Bunnings Warehouse! Lowest prices are just the beginning.
Close the doors!
Hawkling, there's come to life, Sarge!
Not creepy at all, eh?
Oh, that sucks.
It's a good thing you're with Budget Direct, Australia's most award-winning insurer.
Insurance solved with Budget Direct.
You probably already know that I didn't give up.
Oh, look! Goosebumps!
Why? Oh, yeah. Makes sense.
Audible. Start your free trial today.
Finish tablets versus extreme challenges. Engineered for tough conditions. And Finish Ultimate Plus delivers a deep clean without pre-rinsing. And save up to 180 litres of water a week with your dishwasher. What's your Finish challenge?
Unlike FPOS deals that banks serve up to businesses, switching to SmartPay really stacks up. It's how thousands save thousands on FPOS fees. Remember, SmartPay does FPOS. Smarter.
With more mango and less seed, Calypso mangoes are totally irresistible.
Everybody loves the Calypso man!
I can be mistaken for being this dumb big Arab from Western Sydney. And I want them to say that. That's the complete opposite. I know I'm a genius.
He's a smiling assassin!
He's a dangerous player.
George was the closest thing we had to an Arab being on TV, and we loved it. I'm here to finish what he couldn't do. I will still rise.
Award season is well and truly underway. It's time to look at what's making news in the entertainment world with Angela Bishop. And Ange, Hollywood celebs have stepped out in some noteworthy looks today.
They have indeed, and in case you think it seems like we have an award show every day at the moment, we pretty much do. And that's because of the actors and writers strike last year, and a lot of them were all rescheduled to this 2-week period. So we've got the Emmys tomorrow in case you have withdrawals over the next 24 hours. But today it's the Critics' Choice Awards, taking us on the race to the Oscars, and it saw a flock of stars flaunting their best angles. Dua Lipa, Lenny Kravitz, Harrison Ford and Calista Flockhart, Elizabeth Debicki, I'm going to slow down a bit so we can take a look at some of these. Yeah. Emily Blunt, Sarah Snook, Billie Eilish, some of the names.
It's Harrison Ford.
Yes, and Calista, there's Elizabeth Debicki looking fantastic. Mm. She, of course, nominated for her work in The Crown. Then we have Emily Blunt with Paul Giamatti. Sarah Snook looks amazing.
Yes.
Of course, nominated for her work in Succession. Billie Eilish nominated for her song from the Barbie movie, and they all shared their excitement before the awards. Here's a listen.
Every day I'm excited to wake up and come to this stuff and be a part of it all. It's very cool.
Arms length.
It's covered in velour.
It's shades.
I don't want to talk about it. I want to talk about the morning show.
Okay, what do you want to say about the morning show?
I just want to stand next to it. I want to be near it. That's it. Go on.
The most nominated show this evening, by the way.
Did we just pass Pedro?
Pedro. Are you a veil?
Four, baby.
Oh, wait. We actually do have a really good party for him. We do.
The no shirt deal.
Yes.
What about it?
I don't have many shirts. You know, I live in the Bahamas. I keep it kind of basic, so you know, I just throw on the jacket and the pants. Keep it easy.
Lifetime Achievement Award on a show that is nominated, a current new show. This is a series of achievements that doesn't end.
Oh, well, it all ends at a certain point. Yeah. And it's a lifetime, so there's an end. Okay. Yeah? I'm grateful for the attention.
Yes, Harrison Ford's immense contribution to cinema is spotlighted with a Lifetime Achievement Award, while Barbie star America Ferrera received the See Her Award, which celebrates an actress who defies stereotypes and pushes boundaries. Another boundary-pushing actress in attendance was, of course, Margot Robbie. The Aussie superstar swapped out her Barbie core pink for a show-stopping red custom Balmain gown, reminiscent of Mattel's 1996 Radiant Rose Barbie. She was joined by her husband and fellow producer of Barbie, Tom Ackley, and she spoke of Barbie's enduring success.
You really care what the critics think, so it's so nice when they... It's also nice in the instance of Barbie to know that the general public loved the movie and the critics loved it. I feel like so rarely do movies kind of have... Does it meet in the middle like right. that? So it's lovely.
Yeah. I would imagine this past summer must have been the summer of your life. What? It was, a phenomenon. There's nothing, that you can't describe it any other way. Whoa. What have the last few months been like for you?
Really pink, really busy, really fun.
Like the Golden Globes, the Critics' Choice Awards honour the best in film and television. So four Australians are nominated tonight. Margot Robbie, Sarah Snook for Succession, Elizabeth Debicki, and Poor Things screenwriter Tony McNamara. I'll get that in a second. And Elizabeth Debicki has already won Best Supporting Actress in the Drama Series category for her portrayal of Princess Diana in The Crown.
This role has been an incredible gift to me. It has been an incredible challenge, a terrifying challenge, and I will always be grateful for it. I hope, my only hope really was that I would do this remarkable woman, incredible, glorious human, proud by playing her in this show.
Other early winners include Robert Downey Jr. for Best Supporting Actor in Oppenheimer, Billy Crudup for Best Supporting Actor in Morning Wars, and Beef stars Ali Wong and Steven Yeun. And much to Ryan Gosling's surprise, the Barbie ballad I'm Just Ken won Best Song, beating Billie Eilish's What Was I Made For and Dua Lipa's Dance the Night. But Ryan Gosling is much more than just Ken. Overnight, the actor was honoured for his illustrious showbiz career with the prestigious Kirk Douglas Award for Excellence in Film. The Santa Barbara International Film Festival hosted the ceremony that saw Barbie director Greta Gerwig in attendance, as well as Gosling's Crazy Stupid Love co-star Steve Carell, who gave a somewhat heartfelt speech.
Tonight I'd like to ask the question, why do I hate Ryan Gosling? It was the end of a shooting week, and we were standing outside our trailers, and we were getting ready to leave for the weekend and talking about what our weekend plans would be. And I was going to be spending a quiet evening and weekend with my family. And Ryan told me that his band had a gig that evening. Where, I asked. A senior center in Glendale, he replied. He was going to spend his Friday night playing music for some old folks in Glendale. A movie star would have told that story on a talk show, would have used it, would have gotten some juice out of it. But not Ryan Gosling. He did it just to make some old folks happy. And I find that annoying as hell. Coincidentally, I now live at that very senior center. And every week I hope he comes back, but he's too busy.
Ryan's band, as a matter of interest, is called Dead Man's Bones. Because I asked him about it one stage and we compared appalling band names. And I think his...
Did you have one?
Well, yes, the old Channel 10 band. Hard and Fast from Behind. Yes. Yeah, they match. Anyway, at the podium, Gosling took time to thank Gerwig and Carell for their contributions to his career and made a rare public tribute to his wife, Eva Mendes.
I've gotten to go to the moon, be a motorcycle bank robber, a getaway driver, waltz through the stars, be an elementary school teacher, albeit a crack-addicted one. Become a replicant from the future, a gangster from the past, the lovelorn stuntman, and most recently, thanks to Greta, a 70-year-old crotchless doll. But most importantly, I got to meet the girl of my dreams, Ava Mendez, and have two dream children. I dreamed of one day making movies, and now movies have made my life a dream.
Oh, he really is that person.
He is much,
that we could
much
all
more
be jealous
than
of.
Just Ken, indeed. Yeah. No wonder Steve Carell finds him so terribly annoying. That's absolutely right. Past winners of that award that Ryan Gosling received from the Santa Barbara International Film Festival include Dame Judi Dench, Harrison Ford is getting another one today, Jane Fonda and Hugh Jackman. Well, it's been a while since the Gladiators heard the order to assemble, but tonight's the night. The brand new Gladiators hits our screens with hosts Bo Ryan and Liz Ellis, an unbelievable team of athletes, and one familiar face known as Hammer. Nearly 30 years ago, the Gladiators had us glued to our TVs.
An experienced British Green Beret soldier, this guy is trying to put up a good fight.
And now they're back, bigger and better than ever.
Now, a new era begins as a fresh wave of warriors take up their call.
My name is Electra, and Electra is quiet and unassuming, the smallest gladiator of the bunch, a lot like myself, but delivers a shockingly good performance every time.
I'm Viking. I mean, I come in, I don't say much, I've got the look to go with it.
In real life, Electra is Alethea Boone, a three-time Commonwealth Games competitor. And how does it compare to competing in a Commonwealth Games?
One thing I thought was that I was done with Lycra. Apparently not. We're back in it again.
Jed Kenny is the offspring of champions Lisa Curry and Grant Kenny, and a champion surf lifesaver in his own right.
Oh, it's definitely been engraved in me from a young age. I mean, mum and dad strived to be the best, and they were the best. I mean, both representing Australia at the Olympics, so top-tier athletes.
Those who remember the original series will recognise the Pyramid and Jewel, but there are loads of new games as well, and best of all, the successful contenders get the biggest prize of all, to become Gladiators. And keeping an eye on everyone is the ref, who might look a bit familiar, because back in the day, he was Hammer. I found a little something. Which I think
smells like mothballs.
Yeah, here you go. Hold it up. I reckon you could whip this on.
Well, Bo tried it on. And I'll say to him what I said to him is that he needed to raid my sock drawer for starters.
Fighting words, Hammer. I think Bo might want to write a reply on that. You can catch the Gladiators going head-to-head tonight at 7:30 on 10 and 10 Plan. Narelda, as I said, award ceremony is coming out the wazoo over the next few days.
All of these looks and all of these fashions for the red carpet, this is like a stylist's dream.
It is. Hair and makeup, stylists, all of those people, publicists. And I think it's great because bear in mind, when the actors and writers were on strike, all of those people were out of work, as well as the actors and writers. And they went a long time with no income. So doing back-to-back frocks, makeup, looks and everything for this 2 to 3 week period is going to make up a lot of lost ground for them. So it's great.
It's like an economy within itself, isn't
Indeed.
It?
Indeed.
All of those people involved.
100%. Mm. The team, the glam squads, as they're called. They're important people, as you and I both know.
Well, what's the glam squad like for like a big star?
For Margot Robbie?
Yeah.
Probably about 8 people.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, from frock to makeup to publicist on the day to all of the rest.
Yeah, there'd be someone just for like jewellery.
Jewellery.
Just for shoes.
Yeah, shoes.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, you know what that's like. Don't you?
We've got 10 styling and I don't think there's any better in the business. I'm just going to put that
true,
out there.
Very true. Well, they all look amazing.
They do.
As do you. Thank you very much,
Thanks,
Ange. Thank you. Now, returning to our top story today, a new royal era in Denmark. The country now not only has a king, but an Australian-born queen. Our correspondent, Alice Hogg, was there.
Well, Denmark has a new king and an Australian-born queen who've been welcomed by enormous crowds in Copenhagen. They came from near and far, and while it wasn't snowing at the time, they were undeterred by the cold to watch history unfold. From when the then Crown Prince and Crown Princess left their palace residence by car to their appearance on the balcony of Christiansborg Palace following the abdication of popular Queen Margrethe II with the stroke of a pen when she passed the throne to her son, making him Denmark's King Frederick X. Many Australians were in these crowds too, later packing out an event hosted by the Australian ambassador. And before this snow arrived, Copenhagen's sky was lit up in bursts of red and white as a fireworks show marked the end of a significant day for the nation.
Alice Hogg in the snow there. The men's autumn-winter collections for 2024 have hit the runway at Milan Fashion Week. Emporio Armani took inspiration from the high seas, while Dolce & Gabbana named their collection sleek. Gucci's new creative director, Sabato De Sarno, also unveiled his debut menswear collection to rave reviews, designed to capture the joy of life. It featured statement bags, uniformed suiting, and nods to the brand's storied past. A final check of the day's weather for you. And Sydney, the rain continues today, a top of 24. It's also pouring at times for Brisbane, 30 today. Canberra, some showers and 20. Melbourne, mostly sunny skies of 28. Hobart, 23 and mostly sunny. The sun is out for Adelaide, 34, and mostly sunny for Perth, 34. And that's the latest for this Monday, the 15th of January. Buddha, good afternoon.
Today on an all-new Dr. Phil, he says his fiancée needs...